Hello everyone, welcome back to your favorite CAD prep channel Quantifiers. In the daily DILR series, today is a very special day. Why? Because we have completed half century, we have completed 50 sets and it's been almost 2 months. And this journey has been amazing so far. I personally have improved, to be very honest. And I am glad that when I receive texts from each single one of you that we have improved this much, we have done this, I scored this in mock or that in mock, but whatever. I am really loving this journey and I hope you all are enjoying too. Okay. So, first of all, if you wish to be the part of this journey, this course, you need to do what is mentioned over here. Okay. Then, let's see what's ahead. Now, also, before we move ahead, like always, this is a special course, especially for the people who fear DILR. If you do, this is a course specifically made for you. Now, today's set is a binary logic set. How do we get into the binary logic? What is binary logic? Let's find out. In binary logic, the statements are given something like this, that there are three or four or some people, like in this question, it is said that there are three friends, A, B, and C. They have made three statements about three shapes drawn on the blackboard. Okay. It is known that one of them is a truth teller. Truth teller means the person who always tells the truth. One speaks a random mixture of truth and lies. Okay. That person is called alternator. So the important point is a random mixture. There is no pattern like truth, lie, truth, lie, like we generally have. In this case, a person can be like lie, lie, truth, lie, truth, lie, something like this or anything. Okay. So anything can be done. And the third one is a liar. So there are three categories of people. One is a truth teller, one is a liar, and one is an alternator. And all of them have made some statements. So let us just read what all of them says. So what is our duty in this, or how do we do such sets? There are two ways. First, I have to assume someone to be a truth teller. I have to assume someone to be a truth teller, then I have to check for the consistency. For example, if I am assuming A to be a truth teller, then all his statements are true according to me. All the statements should be consistent, and whatever he says should be consistent with other two. So if it is consistent, A will be declared as truth teller. Otherwise, we will move ahead and assume someone else to be a truth teller. Second, we always look for extreme statements. What are extreme statements? Extreme statements are those statements in which a person says something like A is definitely a liar, B is definitely a truth teller, C can never do this, I can never do this. These are the kind of statements which are extreme statements, which are our starting point in this kind of set. Okay. Now, let's see who has made some extreme statements and we will assume him to be a truth teller. So see, A is saying that B is a liar, C is a liar. So if I am assuming A to be a truth teller, according to him, this statement is true, this is true and this is true. But according to him, there are two liars. According to A, there are two liars if I am assuming A to be a truth teller, which is a false assumption. Why? Because their people are of three categories. A truth teller, a liar and an alternator. So this is definitely not true, which means A cannot be a truth teller. Let's see about C. Let's see if I check C, if C is a truth teller. If C is a truth teller, this is true, and this is true. If I check the second statement of B, C, C's second statement is B is a truth teller. If B is a truth teller, then can I say there will be two truth tellers again, C himself and B, according to which C, which is again the wrong assumption because there cannot be two truth tellers. So this is also false. Now, this is he cannot be a truth teller, C cannot be a truth teller, therefore B is a truth teller and all the statements that B has made are true statements. This is one thing. Then, what's next? Let's see what is he saying. Two of the shapes are squares. So I know that out of three shapes, two have to be squares. Third shape, I don't know. Okay. Okay. Now let's check the statements of C. C says at least two of them have four sides each. And I can see that at least two of them have four sides each. Therefore, this statement has to be true. Definitely. Okay. C. And then he's saying B is a truth teller. If B is a truth teller, this statement is also true because B actually is a truth teller. Now B is also a truth teller. Now, remember one thing. There cannot be more than one truth teller. There cannot be more than one. Therefore, C has to make the third statement lie in order to become an alternator. C cannot be a liar. C can either be a liar or an alternator because B is already a truth teller. Therefore, C is an alternator and third statement is a lie. Now, this is again done. Then truth, truth. truth and lie, third statement, lie. And what does the third statement say? Third statement says that one of the shape is circle, which means according to C, one of the shape is a circle, which is a false statement. Therefore, third statement is not a circle. Third object is not a circle. I'll remember this. A has to be a liar. A is saying two of them are circle, which is a lie. B is a liar, is a lie. C is a liar, is a lie. So these three are real lies. Let's see what are the questions in front of us. First is, which of the following can be the list of three shapes? I know there have to be two squares. So two squares, one overall, two squares, one circle. One circle cannot happen. Why? Because third step, I don't know what is the third shape, but I know that it is definitely not a circle. So two squares and one oval is the right answer. Then C statement, truth, truth, lie. Truth, truth, lie. Fourth option. Truth, truth, and lie. Okay. Who is a truth teller? B is a truth teller. Done. And last, a fourth person, D, makes three statements. What kind of person is he? A is not the alternator. A is not an alternator. This is a truth statement. This is true. Okay. Now, second statement. All of the three figures are quadrilateral. See, two of them are definitely quadrilateral. I am not sure about the third one. So I don't know whether this statement is a true statement or a false statement. It can either be true or it can either be false. So it can either be a truth or it can be a lie. Okay. Third statement. At most, one of C's statement is true. But C's two statements are true. And he's saying at most one statement is true. Which means this is a lie. So first statement is definitely a truth. Last is definitely a lie. Which means this person has to be an alternator, because he cannot have all truths or all lies. So this is definitely an alternator. So this completes my set. A good one in order to understand that how the game works. But yes, we have learned something. And at the end, if you wish to be part of this journey, join us as soon as possible. Thank you so much, guys. Have a great day.